Okay, peeps, we at it again here with another fun video. I think it is. It's called "I Am Done with Vim." I'm not a big Vim fan. I think it's too much for 99% of people that are using it and want to use it. I just saw this video while I was looking around the interwebs and was like, I have no idea who this Primage or who the fuck he is or what he's doing or anything like that. I just saw I'm done with Vim, and apparently he's a software engineer and programmer. And if you hear a lot of noise in the background, I have some neighbors that are moving out, it looks like. So let's see what this guy is saying about Vim that a lot of you guys love.
Time for a hot take. I will not be using Vim 9, and I think Vim 9 script is a mistake. So this might be a bit shocking. Some people are like, ugh. But let me tell you why I think that. Now, Vim 9 script has been going on for a while now. It's been under development for quite some time, and it just recently released. Now, a lot of people are very excited about it. It adds types, which types are fantastic. I love types, but it is a breaking backwards compatibility change to Vim script 9.
That's not good. Again, don't know much about Vim. Don't use it. Again, I think it's a power tool that have specific abilities that are really, really catered to a specific crowd of people. If you're just changing your host name, you should not be using Vim. Use Nano or some of the, you know, are really simple editor. If you are a coder, Vim may be for you or Emacs or some of those, but breaking backwards compatibility for something like that's developing software, it's not a good idea in general.
Vim 9 script, whatever it is, I don't even know the name. So what's my problem with it? Well, my problem isn't that Vim 9 script exists. My problem is that when presented with a problem that can be fixed by devoting days of effort to integrating, say, a better choice for embedded systems such as Lua, great language choice, by the way, or...
I know about Lua because it's used a lot in gaming, and it's used a lot for a game I used to play a lot, World of Warcraft, for making add-ons. So I've been messing around with Lua, and it's an amazing scripting language. I really, really like it.
MicroPython, great language choice. You don't even have to be like NeoVim. You could use MicroPython. Nonetheless, inventing your own language for a bespoke editor experience is almost, it just feels absolutely like the wrong decision to make here.
It feels a little bit arrogant, as far as I can, not a Vim expert, but it looks like there is a problem, and there's already solutions out there. What do the GNU people do? I think Vim is made by GNU, if I'm not mistaken here. What do? They build their own instead of just implementing fine-tuning existing solutions. They are reinventing the wheel. Oh, wait, that's something Linux do or open source do a lot. Why could that be? Egos.
Follow Emacs, follow anything, just don't invent your own. The amount of hours that you have to spend building this, the amount of time that's going to be taken into the language specs, into the tokenizer, into the parser, into the semantic analyzer, the amount of just bugs that are going to be just throughout the system for the next decade because of a decision made to write your own language instead of just using something off the shelf is just mind-boggling to me.
Again, it's typically GNU. I have to check it because I get a little bit. I haven't used Vim in forever. I need to see if it's a GNU project. It don't seem like it's a GNU project, but it bears a lot of the. Yeah, it's not a GNU project. So I was wrong there. But I still stand by that it's a problem that we have within open source development that. People, they know that there are existing solutions out there, but they don't control it, or they can't get their will, or they don't have ultimate control over it. Well, the same as controlling it. Or the developers is not willing to implement things in the way that they want. So what do? They develop their own. And then we have all these competing, not standard, but competing products with each other, and they're all buggy as hell, and they all don't really work that well. In this case here, like Lua and MicroPython is really, really well documented, well researched, well coded projects. So yeah, again, it sounds a little bit mental that they're developing their own language for handling this problem that they have here.
I love Vim. I think it's the greatest text editor of all time.
No,
but this is a
No. Notepad. How could you? Notepad, you fool.
Catastrophic mistake, and I truly believe Vim will not be around much longer. Meaning that it will not be in the eye of popularity much longer. Instead, NeoVim will become, you know, the thing that is the popular one. It already is more popular, but it's gonna just vastly gain momentum because of this. And the reason being is that while Vim 9 script was being written, tested, still probably not 100%, probably bugs lurking all over the place, NeoVim was able to create an LSP client that is dynamite. They're able to integrate TreeSitter, which offers you an AST inside your editor to be able to write amazing plugins. And it's using a language we can all just Google. It's a simple language. It doesn't have anything very surprising about it. And they built all the APIs for you to be able to integrate with it. And there's a language server that integrates with all this. So you actually get really great updates.
I'm sold. I'm fucking sold, dude. Yeah, like if he presented, if I was looking into starting learning Vim or NeoVim, he just sold me on NeoVim. Why overcomplicate things? Why do we need to overcomplicate things? He just sold me on NeoVim.
So for me, this was just like so painful. Like why?
Why? Why?
Would you do
why?
This? When you are given an opportunity to break backward and you can make a clean start going forward, pick something that's going to be a benefit to everybody. And this is really a good moral lesson, I think, for a lot of us, which, you know, I'm not going to lie, I've made some bad decisions. I have definitely had a not built here problem before, and I have chosen to build things that I should have just used an off-the-shelf solution. And the reality is, like, not all off-the-shelf solutions are going to, you know, 100% meet your needs. True. But if it meets at 99%, giving back to the community, trying to drive the change for that last percentage is categorically simpler than building it yourself almost always.
And I think it comes down to what I said before, ego. You know, ego and the control that you have, that you build it yourself. You know, you are the fucking king of this thing. You know, you are not reliant on other people. You are the one, the alpha. You know, you are the top fucking dog. But it comes with a lot of fucking problems. And sometimes you have to eat some humble pie and be like, you know what? I could reinvent the wheel, or I could just polish and put some extra spokes or something like that, or some spikes into this already existing wheel to make it fit my need. And like he said, give that back to the community, talk with the community, work with other people, instead of being an arrogant, self-righteous, I know best kind of mentality, kind of dude or girl, and making everything myself and reinventing everything myself because the way I do it is better than how everyone else is doing it.
So yes, I am actually greatly disappointed. I'm sorry. I'm just trying to celebrate the new release of Vim 9 with everybody by absolutely taking a hot take on it. So you're not going to cash me outside using Vim Script 9. Instead, I'm going to be sticking with NeoVim, and I have decided that there is no looking back. It's actually one of the reasons why I've decided to go full Lua for my Vim config. Mm-hmm. I have for the longest time been holding out using Vim Script for a large portion of it because I didn't want to have to break that. And if I wanted to go back to Vim, I kind of wanted that door to be open. But this felt like, you know what? For the last couple years, it seems like the NeoVim team banging on all cylinders. You know, a lot of group consensus, a lot of building things together. Vim, not building things together. It does not, at least it doesn't appear that way. Really seems like one person's decision. Really doesn't seem like it's going in the direction that's going to be beneficial to its user base. Now, I know I'm going to probably lose some subs for having such a hot take. So if you want to help, press that sub button, baby. Oh yeah, come on! And yes, new Vim series coming soon. My name is The Primogen. I hope that you like this. This is actually a retelling of the hot take that I did live on Twitch. So if you like hot take...
Oh, he's on Twitch apparently. Again, I'm not a Vim guy. I know nothing about Vim, to be honest. I think I used it one time, the same with Emacs. Used that one or twice back in the day when in the 90s where everyone was telling me about it and raging about it and it was the thing to do, and I edit the host name or something like that in it. I'm like, no, fuck that shit. But I get what he's saying though, because this is not problems or things that only are happening within like editors or coders. This is something that happens a lot just in life in general. Sometimes ego and arrogancy takes over. We need to be aware of that. You know, we need to be careful that we are not shooting ourselves and other people in the foot by thinking we know best and we are better. Because most of the time, we are not. So yeah, anyway, see you all later. Bye-bye.